Welcome to Morning Makeup with Radiant Shay. I am your host, which is Miss Shay. Welcome to my morning and getting ready with me as I get ready for work. I am in my Tarte palette doing a natural look this morning. I thought I was recording it. Evidently, I wasn't. I have my face prepped and ready to go. Like I said, I'm in my Tarte palette. I am doing the color Ember out of my Tarte palette. And I just wanted to do a natural look this morning, because I have a lot of things that I need to get done this morning. Normally I do a dramatic look, but today we are going to do a natural look. I hope you guys have a great morning and I hope you guys have a great day. You're going to hear a lot of drawers opening and closing because it's real life. I am getting ready for work and I do my makeup each and every day as I get ready for work. Kind of want to do like a little smoky eye over here just for effect, because that's just me, because I'm extra. But we're gonna make it work. We're gonna make it work. Alright, so now I'm gonna go back into our Tarte palette and we are going to go into the color Onyx, and we're gonna do that in our outer V. I like to hold my eye. I want to make sure this is evenly distributed. You don't need a whole lot, just a little bit going on your outer V. And I already did my eyes and everything before I came on camera, because like I said, I'm getting ready for work, so I just want to show you the eye colors that I do every day. On the weekends, I normally don't wear makeup because I like to let my face breathe away from makeup, because you know, your face needs a break. So I just wash my face, clean it really good with some witch hazel, and this green soap. I can't think of the name of the soap that I use because it's not on my mind right now. And I use 100% shea butter and just spread that all over my face. And I just walk around with that on my face all day. And I do that like starting on Fridays when I come home from work. If I'm not going anywhere, I'll strip all my makeup off and I just walk around with shea butter on my face all weekend. And then come Saturday morning, I wash it back off and repeat and do the same thing and just give my face a break from the makeup. I'm just going in with my brush and blending out the black. Okay, that looks good. So now I am going to take a flat brush and I am going to put, if I can find my flat brush, it's right here. This is Kiss Full Coverage Concealer. I'm just going to do a little bit of this on my flat brush. And I'm going to put that down here just so my color can hold. Okay, do it again. Seems more came out on this side of the eye than the other one. I know I used to get a lot of questions about how long does it take, but since I'm filming, it's going to take me a little bit longer. So So now we're going to go back into our Tarte palette. Everything is going to be out of the Tarte palette this morning. We are going to go to the color and stick, which is the last one. We're going to go in here, dab our brush, and we're going to put this on top of our lid and just dab it on. Dab that color in. Puppy. And just blend that in on the edges. That's gonna be cute. Take our brush that we dipped in that ember, and we're going to fluff it out. I said this was going to be a natural look. It's more dramatic. Oh well, that's just me. That's my personality. Okay, so now we're going to go in back in the same palette. We're going to go into sand, and this is going to be used as our highlight. And I hope you guys can hear me, because the last time I was recording and I thought I had the volume up, it wasn't up. Then I bought a mic. The mic didn't work. It was defective. So I had to send it back. And in the process of sending it back, Friday while I was at work, I get a notification from Amazon. The same mic that I ordered is on its way. I'm like, I don't like this mic. I'm sending it back. Why are they sending me another one? Needless to say, today on my way to work or on my way home, I'm sending both those mics back. Amazon can have it. Just give me my money back. Because it was a waste of my time and my money to buy that mic, and it didn't work. All right, so now we're going to go into our eyes. We're going to do the outline on top of our eyelids with this e.l.f. eyeliner. Okay, hold on. I see something I don't like. Yeah, when it comes to my face, I'm a mess. Okay. For those who are new to my channel, welcome. Welcome to Becoming a Heart. You can leave comments down in the comment section of looks that you want to see. On my previous video, I mimicked a look from a Pinterest board, which came out really cute. Kind of impressed with myself. Okay, we got our eyes outlined. I am going to go in with my Maybelline Colossal Mascara. I like this mascara. There's another one out there that my best friend was telling me about, but I gotta ask her what it is. And then once I put my mascara on, we are going to go in with our, these are by Kiss, which is called Duchess Eyelashes. We're going to put those on. I am going to do my mascara right now, get my eyes prepped. I'm going to put my lashes on off camera because it's easier for me that way to do it off camera. One last thing I gotta do. So what's some things that you guys like to do with your makeup routine? Do you like colors? Do you just like neutrals? Do you like pinks? What do you like? Let me know. And what kind of foundations do you use for yourself? Me, I like the Fit Me foundation. And sometimes it's kind of hard for me to find the Fit Me foundation in my color, which is Cappuccino. For some reason, it's always gone when I need to go back and get it. So I had to end up ordering off of Amazon just to have my color. I'm willing to try some different colors, but I'm kind of persnickety about my foundation because it's kind of hard for me to find my exact shade to match my neck and all that. It is what it is. Okay, I am going to get off camera. I'm going to put my lashes on and I'll be right back. And then we're going to finish. Okay, I got my eyelashes on and ready to go. Now it's time for foundation, which is, like I said, the Fit Me Cappuccino Foundation. And this is in the Matte Poreless. I'm going to pour some of this on the back of my hand. I like to put my foundation on with a brush. Some people like to use a beauty blender, which is fine. Everybody has their own preference. I just prefer to use a brush to put my foundation on. And I like to use the beauty blender to do my contour. Although the contour that I do, because I don't do a lot of contouring. I do like under my eyes and my forehead. And that's about it. Every now and then I might, you know, start down here. It depends on how I'm feeling that day. Which is not a lot. So what are some of the things you guys like to do on the weekends when you don't have to work? You want to unwind and relax. For me, I like brunches. I do a lot of brunches. I need to plan one for my friends and family. My best friend's brother was telling me that him and his wife wanted to, not that they don't do brunches, they just wanted to have a different group of people to go out with. So I said that, okay, the next time I do one, I'll call you guys and let you know what we're going to do. And then a couple of weeks ago, maybe 2 weeks ago, I ran into my male best friend I haven't seen in years. And I saw him at my best friend's, female best friend's funeral. Me and him had been friends since high school. And we lost contact. Believe it or not, he was married to my best friend. So I have a male best friend. I had two male best friends. One was Mark and the other one, the name was Andre. Andre, which lives in Vegas now, I believe, married my sister's friend and they moved to Vegas and we lost contact. You know how that goes when you marry a woman and you have a female best friend, you gotta put your wife first. That's fine. And then Mark was married to my best friend Cheryl. Life behind the way, stuff happened. I don't want to get in detail what happened, but we lost contact for a long time. And they got a divorce and remarried, and me and him lost contact. So we ran into each other, like I said, at her mother's funeral. And me, him, and his cousin are all good friends. So I'm going to plan a brunch for all of us to get together and go out to brunch. And I need to plan one for my family so our family can stay in contact, because there's too many of us in this area and we don't get together enough. But that's a different story. So anyway, what do you guys like to do on the weekends after a long week of work and to unwind and get your weekend started? Now I'm going to go into my concealer, which is a full coverage concealer by Kiss Pro Touch. You can use any concealer you want. I just want to give this a try because I happen to be in the beauty store. I was like, let me try this. I like to try different stuff. And so far, it hasn't failed me at all. I like it. I'm just going to go in with that. Get this started. There's this one place. It's in Westport that I like to go to. And they do these mimosa towers. As you know, I love a mimosa. And who doesn't? I want to try to do a brunch here at my house before it gets too cold outside. And do it on the back patio for me and my girls. Just to sit out and have fun and talk and have a little bit of girl time. Because you need that. I don't have a significant other, so out of my best friends, I'm the only one that's not in a relationship. Okay, so I'm gonna let this do its thing. And I need to hurry and get this done because I don't want, it's almost time for the people in my house to wake up. And then that little 2-year-old, when he gets up, oh honey, he's live and awake. And he will barge in this room and let you know he is here. And I do not want to wake him up yet. I want him to stay asleep till I get this done. Okay, now we're going to blend this out. Because once he get up, oh honey, he is awake. Or was that Saturday? Yeah, Saturday. He had my phone. Because his, if I'm a grandmother, I don't look like it, but I'm a grandmother. I'm 51. Who knew? I look good for 51. Anyway, he had my phone, and he was talking to his mama while she was at the grocery store picking up something because we were making carne asada, and I needed something else, so she went to the store. And so in the process of doing that, she hung up. And he hit Duo on my phone. So he proceeds to call my sister on Duo. And talk about, is that auntie? Is that auntie? I was like, boy, if you don't give me my phone. And he was walking around the whole house talking to her on the phone, which was hilarious. I was like, this dude is a trip. He is in his own element, in his own world half the time. So now we're going to go in with our translucent powder to set our face, which is going to be Airspun. Grab some of this. I think that's leftover from. You're going to hear a lot of tapping too, just by the way. So you know. Like I said, this is real life. And this is how I put my makeup on every day. And I'm usually up around 5:15 every morning because I start my day up every morning. I need to read. I don't like to read my word every morning before I get up. Because that's the only time that I'm going to have time to read my Bible, study that early in the morning because the whole house is asleep. And I can't do it. I try it in the afternoons, like when I come home from work, make dinner. Sometimes, I mean, you know, make dinner. My daughter makes dinner too, but you know, try to sit down and read at like 8 o'clock at night just to have that quiet time. There is no quiet time because when you have a 2-year-old running around, he's making a whole bunch of noise doing his thing and he's demanding, you know, for him to be in here with his nanny. And I don't want him in here when I'm trying to read. So I ask God to make a way for me to read every day to spend time with him. I get up at 5:15 every morning anyway. And when I get up, I procrastinate on getting up. So I was like, why don't I just read in the morning? So God made a way for me to read at 5:15 in the morning. So I get up, read, spend at least 45 minutes with him, read my word. And then I get up and start doing my makeup. Well, this morning, I woke up about 3:45. I could not go back to sleep. I was like, I might as well just go on and get up. So needless to say, I've been up really since about, I actually got to bed about 4:30. And I started reading in and I was like, let me go on and start recording, doing my makeup because they're still asleep and I can get this done. So I had to get my daughter for a morning when I do record the day before. Look, I'm recording in the morning, so you need to take Aiden and I'm tapping makeup. My powder, I'm sorry, I'm going into, I got the top on this, hold on. I told you, you need to take Aiden and hold him down until I get through recording. Because if I don't let them know I'm recording, they'll bust in here. And you'll hear them all over the place, especially him. And she'll come in making all kind of noise. Okay, so we're going to the Fit Me Loose pattern. This was a medium deep 30. I don't know if you can see that. My ring light is in the way. But yeah, that's what that is. Okay, and we're just tapping up powder and going in and putting it around my face. That's my daughter gonna say, what hair are you holding? None. And there's really not a whole lot I need to do to my hair in the morning because I tie it down with a silk scarf and I make my own hair grease, and I usually use like a hair whip by Kintu in my hair, but every time I go around there, they're out. I can never find my stuff. Now I'm going to take a fluffy brush and just wipe off the existing powder. I have a routine every Friday. Like when I do my makeup, I have a bucket that sits here on the floor. I dry my makeup brushes in there at the end of the week and I wash them. So like I come in from work Friday, I try to do it on Friday. It's always ended up being Saturday, and I'll, you know, clean my brushes a couple of times, and then come Sunday, you know, they should be halfway dry, and I just leave them sitting in the bucket, and then come Monday morning, my brushes are done. And it goes for my beauty blender too. So now let's look into putting on some blush. I'm just going back and getting off any existing powder. Let's find a blush to put on. We are going to do, hold on. Okay, we are going to go into this Wet n Wild blush. This is in the color peach. It says keep it peachy. So we are going to do that blush. I just want to do something light. I don't want to do just tapping off the powder. You can't see it because it's peachy. You really can't see it. You know, you're like, why didn't you put on the dark powder come to your face? This is the way I like to do my makeup. As Tab would say, it's her business, my face, my business. Okay? That's that. And so now we're going to go into our highlight, which is the same highlight I use all the time, which is this Madison Miller Sea Shimmer Highlighter. You can't see it, but I can see it. Okay. Now we're going to go into our eyeliner, which is going to be this LA Girl Glide eyeliner, which is, I love this eyeliner. It's easy to go on. And I found out about this eyeliner from Creative Diva. This was a long time ago. Because I was trying to find an eyeliner that would glide on. And when I tell you, honey, this glides on like butter, it glides on like butter. And once I'm hooked to something, I'm hooked. Not that I'm not willing to try anything else, but this is just what works for me. Okay. Get that done. Now we need to find a lip color, which more than likely is going to be the same thing that I always use. So let's find a lip color. It's said, it's real life. We're getting ready for work. Okay, so we're going to go into our BH Cosmetics. Y'all, excuse the noise. This is Serenity, which is going to be a matted neutral color. Let's try to find a lip liner that I can use. It's always going to be the same one. I need to buy some different lip liners. I can never seem to find what I want. Okay. So it's going to be this one. It's always this one. I want to find some dark brown lip liners. I can never find one that I want, because basically the ones I have are like either they're always burgundy or they're always a plum color. But yeah, I don't have any dark browns. I thought I did. I'm out. You know what? Hold on. Okay, we're going to use this. I'm going to improvise. This is what I use on my. Don't worry, it's clean. I cleaned it with some alcohol. We're gonna outline our lips. Mac used to sell this chocolate liner. I lost track of it. I gotta go back and find it. Now, this doesn't want to come off. We are going to go into that. This is, like I said, by BH Cosmetics. And this one is in the color Serenity. And this is a matte look. Yeah, I'm trying to get it together. Hold on. Okay. Now we're going to go in with our NYX Butter Gloss. This is in the color Madeline, which is a neutral color. And blend that in. All right, that is the look for this morning. I hope you guys have a great day. Thank you for watching. Have a blessed day. Have a blessed week. And we'll be at it again tomorrow. Don't forget this. Don't let anybody steal your joy, because your joy is the only thing that's going to keep your sanity. I want you to be great. I want you to be beautiful. All right, my loves. Have a great day. Thank you for watching. Hit that like button and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the morning.